Sudan, Islamic schools known as halwas teach children to memorize the Quran. Halwas have existed in Sudan for hundreds of years. There are nearly 30,000 of them, and they're celebrated for providing free education to children across the country. I'm Fatah Al-Rahman Al-Hamdani, a journalist based in Sudan. I went undercover for BBC News Arabic to investigate reports of widespread abuse inside these schools. Since 2018, I've visited 23 halwas across Sudan and witnessed extreme forms of abuse. In many of them, I saw children shackled and chained. Some of them as young as 5 years old. I was shocked to see how routinely they were beaten, punished by the sheikhs who run the schools, or by one of the older students for making mistakes when reciting the Quran. The children looked unhealthy and malnourished. Many forced to sleep on the floor in extreme heat. And sick children were left without medical help. During the course of the investigation, I came across a story that disturbed me more than anything else I had seen. Two 14-year-old boys, Ismail and Mohammed Nader, who are savagely beaten inside a halwa in Omdurman. I visited them immediately in Bari Hospital in Khartoum. Their injuries were horrific and barbaric. The day after the attack, the police arrested the sheikh in charge of the halwa and three teachers. Two of them were charged with assault. The sheikh and one other were charged with perverting the course of justice. But they were all released on bail, and the halwa remained open. In 2018, I'd filmed inside the halwa in which Mohammed Nader and Ismail were horrifically beaten. Halwa Al-Khulafa Al-Rashidin, run by this man, Sheikh Hussein.
حاولت انه اعمل استكشاف عام من ضمن المباني في واحد قال لي ده السجن.
This is the prison Mohammed Nader and Ismail were locked inside and tortured. They were given no food or water for 5 days. Children here were shackled for bad behavior or for trying to escape. Teachers kept a close eye on the children as they recited their lines, standing over them with a whip. The conditions here were the worst I had seen. It's no wonder Mohammed Nader and Ismail tried to escape. The boys' injuries were so severe, the doctors didn't think they would survive. They had to undergo months of surgery and physiotherapy.
انا عاوز العالم كله يشوف ما يكون مخفي.
قلنا خلاص نمشي بس الناس اللي قدموهم العداله. لان اصلا ما دارين انه يساومونا بالقرش ولا اثنين ثلاثه، لانه احنا لو خلينا حكايه زي دي في حاجات انا متاكده اكثر من ده ثاني حتحصل.
Sheikhs wield so much power in their communities that it's rare for families like Mohammed Nader's to press charges. But In 2018, a revolution started in Sudan. The old regime was overthrown, and a transitional government was established, promising change and reform. Ismail and Mohamed Nader's families believe that in this new Sudan, they can get justice.
يعني مهما كلفني انا الحقيقه دي بقولها يعني ما بخاف منها.
Mohamed Nader's family are on their way to court. It will be the first time they face the alleged perpetrators. An hour later, the boys and their families leave court, but not with the news they wanted. The judge postponed the trial because one of the defendants failed to show up.
محمد قال لي شو في جد حسين شايفة يسبح يسبح
حسيت كان مش هدقه كان دايرهم يتحاكم بس.
But with every day that goes by, children continue to suffer inside Kharwas across Sudan. In the suburbs of Khartoum, I got to explore the Kharwa of Haj al-Dali. While the sheikhs were busy with the evening prayer, I found a room full of whips and chains. In another, a young boy was crying. He was scared and desperate to go home. The Halwa of Haj al-Dali told the BBC that a new sheikh is now in charge and that chaining and beating have stopped. In North Darfur, I filmed secretly inside the Halwa of Ahmed Hanafi, one of the biggest and most respected. Inside a study session, I watched as a child was subjected to more than 30 lashes for arguing with another student. When we contacted the Halwa, the sheikh confirmed that they do beat children as a form of discipline, but denied this incident took place. In Sudan, all forms of violence against children are illegal, and the new transitional government says that they are taking the matter of abuse in Khalwas seriously.
اللي انتوا عايزينها تكون شنو؟
الناس اللي بيدرسوا فيها لازم يكون عندهم مستوى بتاع تعليم محدد ومعين. الامر الاخر وده الامر المهم انه المنهج الذي يدرس في الخلوة يكون واضح.
يعني اذا الضرب والتقييد وكذا ما من ضمن الاولويات
بتاعتك؟ كله لابد انه يكون بمعيار واضح، لا ضرب ولا تعذيب ولا انتهاك لاي حق من حقوق الانسان او حقوق الطفوله على الاطلاق.
Mohamed Nader is recovering, but he's struggling with his mental health and is afraid to go to school.
Yes.
He's beginning to open up about what happened to him and Ismail.
اسماعيل قام فات قبضه وانا داير تلف الزن الناس اللي من الصلاه قاموا عرفونه بعد حسين سافر ماليزيا فات جاب الطب والستارات وجاب الشيطان هلا قاموا دقونا انا قاموا ربطوني نومنا على بطني قاموا دقونا يعني الدق ده ما بحصل في يوم واحد بيجيبوا ناس كتار الناس بيكونوا نايمين يعني ما عارف انا من زمان لقيت نفسي في مستشفى بس
طيب ما قلت لهم يا خلونا ونحن ما دايرين نطلع وكده
انا كان قافل لك خشمك هات تعمل خلونا
انت ممكن توريني ليه؟
أكثر هاي والخلوة في الاقتصاد ده هديلة نادوك رجالك يعني
حصل قدامك يعني مثلا لولد؟
يعني
Mohammed Nader told us that rape was carried out by older students. And although he wasn't sexually abused, several other people told the BBC that rape happened in the Harwa under the management of Sheikh Hussein. Over the course of our investigation, we've seen sheikhs operate with impunity. Halwas in which abuse has taken place have remained open, leaving hundreds of children vulnerable. And families like Mohammed Nader's have been left to fight for justice on their own.
Hello?
It was time to meet Sheikh Hussein and put these allegations to him.
Assalamu alaikum.
The trial of Sheikh Hussein and the three other men charged following the assault of Mohammed Nader and Ismail has been postponed 5 times. He was warned by the authorities that if he wanted to keep his halwa open, the chaining of children had to stop. He was keen to show us the changes he'd made.
كله مجانا وسكن مجانا
يعني هنا كان الإصلاحية اللي تم التكفيل بسبب المشكلة
خلاص تمام
وده برضو كان جزء منه يعني
نعم
غرفة لي
نعم فالآن كل رجلنا قرآنية
ممكن ندخل
ندخل
دافي شوية هي
دي المزدحف الجمعنا خلاص ده النهرية دي خلاص يعني تمزق.
The prison in which Mohammed Nader and Ismail were tortured is now nothing more than a storage room. And none of the children here are chained.
في البداية التقييد ده أصله جاي من وين؟ أصله في الدين في ال
هناك حديث قال عجم الأمة هناك أناس من أمته يدخلون الجنة بالسلاسل أنا رجالا خلاوي دي كلها أنا بس كل الخلاوي معظمها يقيدون
في اتهام لأنه في أطفال اثنين هنا ضربوا جوا الخلوة ضرب مبرح قربوا كانوا يموتوا يعني
صح نعم أنا كنت في مؤتمر في ماليزيا يعني الإصلاحية كانت موجودة إصلاحية دي قلت لها الإصلاحية في أبناء يشربون البنجو بتاعت المخدرات والسوليسيون يسرقون يرتكبون المعاصي فأبوي يجيبوا يقيدونا
وضربوهم لشنو يعني؟
والله طبعا يعني رفضوا أن يدرسوا
أنا لقيت مجموعة ذكروا لي إنه يا أخي في اختصاب في الخلف اختصاب للأطفال
يا شيخ اتق الله
رايم هما أنا قلت لك رايم
اتق الله عز وجل
رايم هما
اتق الله عز وجل أنت تخش في مواضيع صعب جدا عليك أن تتقي الله عز وجل لا تحارب القرآن
أنا لا أحارب القرآن
أنت محارب القرآن
أنا لا أحارب القرآن
أسمع القرآن مثبتينه مثبته وإلا ستعاقب عشان كذا
طيب يا شيخ أنا سألتك أنت ممكن تجاوب لي
الآن في حرب شرسة تدار على التعليم الديني يديرها أمثال هؤلاء خيلان جدا لبي بي سي أنا اعطي المايك للأستاذ هنا
We were told to end the interview, but allowed to stay and film the evening prayer. Shortly afterwards, Sheikh Hussein reappeared and wanted another chance to answer our questions.
طيب شيخنا هل عندك أي حاجة عايز تضيفها؟
الحاصل أن الإصلاحية هي أخطأنا خطأ وجل من لا يخطأ واعترفنا بهذا الخطأ والأمر الآن أمام القضاء. أما السؤال الذي سألتني قلت أخبروك أنت سمعت بأنه في هذا المجمع في اختصابات هذا الكلام نستنكره تماما
A few months after this interview, Sheikh Hussein died in a car accident. The charges against him have been dropped and the halwa is now under the control of Sheikh Hussein's brother. He told us that he was always opposed to imprisoning children and that under his management, the beating of children would not be tolerated. He also denied that rape has ever taken place in the halwa.
سكتنا على الموضوع ده يا جماعة. في محمد ده في أخوان يكون ألوف إذا عزم مثلا إنت تضحي بولدك عشان شنو؟ تكريم الله رجل الدين.